make it like a million. Like a million, million, million. You make it like a million. Like a million, million, million. You make it like a million.
Okay.
Like a million, million.
Corinthians chapter 6, verse 18. Please, can you project it and let the church read it together? 1 Corinthians 6:18. If you commit fornication, the Bible tells us that you are doing it inside your body. The evil that that person is bringing and the one you are still struggling with jammed together. Whoa. Let's read it together. Flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is without the body, is outside. But he that committed fornication sinneth against his own body. No wonder the enemy is afflicting bodies. The Bible says we have spirit, we are spirit, we have soul, and we live in the body. When you are born again, your spirit man is born again. But your soul needs the word of God to grow. Your body needs to carry the Holy Ghost. No wonder the Bible tells us, 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19, that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. Your body must be the carrier of the Holy Ghost. When your body carries the Holy Ghost and the soul is being fed with the truth, demon cannot reside in your body. Demon cannot reside. If you take alcohol, they will run into you. If you tell lies, like the example I was giving yesterday, was it yesterday? That I was in London, and a girl bought me Kentucky. Today is our daughter. So I wanted to touch her head and say, thank you very much. And I had this sign on my hand. I said, my God. I said, have you allowed the demons to come back? He said, no. Oh, Pastor Grace, no. I said, don't worry. It's a checkup. The deliverance will not be like the one we did the other time. I must conduct deliverance for you. Before I leave your father's house, I'm staying here. I can't live with what I've seen in my hand. So, in the night when all the visitors left, we started praying. As I started praying for her, you know, this girl, a genius. She plays instruments. Her life is church, house, work. The company took her up to train her to the level of becoming a graduate as an engineer. And she's working with them. They pay her salary and they're going to pay her fees. You will know how brilliant she is. So as I started praying for her, I started hearing some sound. And I said, who are you in this body, you foul spirit? And they started mentioning their name. And it was the co-worker. I said, co-worker, what are you doing? Is she the only one? All the management will be calling her everywhere. All the management will be saying she's good. She's like, can't we be good also? And I said, oh my God, don't you know she's born again? How did you get in here, you foul spirit? He said, that's why she's a loner. Nobody talks to her in the office. She's a loner because she proves to be born again. Then I say, how did you manage to come in here? That's what I always want to know. He said, ha, ha, ha. It was my birthday. She followed us for dinner. And we lure her to take alcohol. She refused to take it. She rejected it. But we lure her into it. And she took it and sipped it. And she put it down. She could not drink it. But she did what? She did what? He said, immediately she sipped it, we came inside her. I said, okay, now, pack your load out of this body. And they were removing things, pulling things from her breast, from her stomach. So as they were pulling it, they were pulling a lot of things. And I said, what are you pulling there? He said, stone. They say what? Stone. From the stomach also. If that deliverance were not conducted, this brilliant, promising girl will fall sick one day. They start to diagnose. They say it's cancer, it's this. They start treatment. But the demon that resides inside her, the impersonating spirit, will never allow any treatment to go through. Eventually, if she gives up the ghost, you know some people will be disappointed. You know some people will not like to serve God again. You know some people will be talking to God anyhow. God, why did you do this? This promising girl. This girl that is always before you on the altar. This girl that plays this instrument. This girl that is so quiet, easy going. Not knowing. A sip has allowed demon to impersonate her. As I was preaching and giving this example somewhere in Republic of Ireland, a man came to me after the service and said, Pastor Grace, one of the ministers, I said, you were preaching about my life. He said, when people die, or when they are sick, and they pray, and the thing is not going, people will not even know what they have done secretly. The only thing they will be openly doing is blaming God. He said, because he spent his money working for God. He spent his life in the church. He's an altar minister. But nobody knew when he fell. He fell into sin. A lady came and made him to sin. But nobody knew. He did not confess it to the pastor. He was still doing everything he was doing. He said, but one day, they just left the camp. After joining the praise and worship team, the GO came, prayed with them. You know, activities. With his money and everything. He was going back home when the armed robber came into his car. He fainted. He thought that he's dead. But when he woke up, he looked here and there. He could not find them again. He didn't know what they saw that made them to just... They left the car. They left him. Then he said to me, he said, if I had died, people will blame God. They say, God, how did you allow this person to go like this? But nobody knows that he has opened a door to the enemy to come in. The gate of heaven is the church of God. The church of God is the pillar and the ground of the truth where you block out demonic interference into the lives of members. Where sickness is blocked out. Where calamity is averted if the truth is preached. What are those things that you are sipping? Not even taking them. You are going to marry. I'm not fornicating with her, but our saliva is touching each other. If your saliva touch the saliva of somebody that is not legally married to you, you are in trouble. Your relationship must be, looketh at me afar off, toucheth me not. I'm telling all of you now. When they tell you, don't be angry. It is in the church that they need to tell you that, you see, unforgiveness is cancer. Unforgiveness is what? Cancer. Malice is what? Cancer. It will eat the physical and send the person to hellfire. So if you want to live on earth as if you are in heaven, you must abide by the truth. The whole truth of the word of God. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 26-27. Ephesians 4, 26-27 says, be ye angry and sin not. Don't allow the sun to go down on your wrath. Neither give a place to the devil. It is the church of God that you need to hear that. When you are angry and you cannot drop it, when you cannot forgive your fellow brother, your husband offended you in the morning till evening, you are still grudging, you have opened the door. The devil will come with John 10:10. Amen. Am I right with John 10:10? What is there? The thief cometh not, but to do what? To steal, to kill, and to destroy. In the name of Jesus Christ, Satan will not destroy us. It is in the church of God that all this should be preached, so as to act as the gate of heaven in our life. When the church cannot speak the truth, then the church is no more the gate of heaven. The truth that is preached will bring healing. We bring deliverance, because himself that is called the truth will surface there. And when the truth surfaces in a place, things, pleasant things, wonderful things start to happen. You start to live on earth. When you are part of that congregation, you will live on earth as if you are living in heaven, because peace will just surround your life. Are you sick in your body? Have you allowed the devil to come in by holding grudge against somebody from, I don't know, the days you've been angry? Tonight, whatever they have deposited into your life, like that young lady, will be out in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you troubled? There is rest around. There is peace in the house. Whatever you are going through in your life, the truth is here tonight to make you free. If only you will allow him, if only you will embrace the truth and say, Lord, I love you, the truth. Whatever they say that is hurting me, I will put things in order. I will never fight the truth. And if you are here, you are not born again. It's an opportunity for you to embrace the truth, so that you can live on earth as if you are living in heaven. So that you will stand at the gate of heaven already. And when the trumpet sound, it will not be difficult for you to just enter into it. Let's rise on our feet. Let's start to talk to God and say, Lord, in any way I have worked against the truth in my life, forgive me, Lord. Have mercy on me. In any way I have worked against the truth. You don't want to hear the truth. They say, forgive somebody. You are saying, it's difficult, Jare. It's difficult. That person has offended me. Please give me some time to be angry with the person. You are against the truth. 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 They are telling you, the relationship you are in is not right. He's an unbeliever. Say, I will manage it. I will manage it. I will manage it. I can't destroy my life. The time is going. The time is fast spent. Yes, you cannot lay down your life. He says, he that lay down his life, we have it. If you hide your life, you will lose it. Lord, in any area I have antagonized the truth, I pray that you have mercy on me. Even myself as the preacher of today, I pray that you have mercy. Have mercy on me. In any way I have antagonized the truth, the Bible tells us that seeking first his kingdom. What are those things that God says you should put in the house of the Lord? Put your money in the house of the Lord. Give them this donation. You say, no, 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 no. I can't do it. Give your life to me. Come and do the work. Come and do the work I ask you to do. Hey, there is no money. There is no money. You say, no, I will go hungry. No, I don't want to kill myself. Brethren, in any way you have been working against the truth, I want you to repent tonight. Lord, have mercy on me. In any area I've worked against the truth, I'm asking for your mercy. 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 In any area I've worked against the truth, I'm asking for your mercy. They said to you, the man that you are with, he's not your wife, he's not your husband. You are the second woman there. You have to leave. You say, hey, the truth is bitter. How can I leave this thing? Lord, have mercy on me. In any area I've worked against the truth, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy. Wash me your blood. Have mercy on me, Lord. Have mercy on me, Lord. Have mercy. In any area, as a preacher of tonight, I have worked against the truth. I am asking for your mercy, O Lord. That your mercy, Father Lord, will work for me tonight. Ma koronde bo shandele bo zokota. Jekekele mo sokontali bo sende. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy. Have mercy on me in the name of Jesus. Let your mercy rule over the judgment of the enemies in my life. Have mercy on me in the name of Jesus. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy. I'm waiting for you. If you want to give your life to Jesus Christ today, please, can you raise up your hand? He's here in the house to save your soul. If you want to identify with the truth, blessed be the name of the Lord. Please, let's plead for mercy, 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 Lord. Have mercy, have mercy. You cannot forgive your husband. You cannot forgive your wife. You've been working against the truth. The Bible says, he that cannot forgive from their hearts, the Heavenly Father will not forgive you also. What has anyone done against you that you cannot let go? Have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, Lord. In any area I've worked against the truth, let your mercy work for me. Let your mercy speak for me. In Jesus' name we pray. We're going to say, in the name of Jesus, in any way I've opened myself to the enemy, whatever they have dropped into my life, Holy Ghost fire, destroy them. Any deposit of the enemy, in any area I've opened up myself, let the fire destroy the deposit of the enemy. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire. Destroy whatever the enemy has deposited into my life. In any way I've opened up to them, whatever they have deposited thus far, let your fire destroy them. Let your fire destroy them. Makerebo bo 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 ronde bo shekenya. Marabakendele bo zokronde bo shekenya. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to pray because I know we are cleansed right now. We are going to pray that the power of God will touch the AC in this church, because the people that repaired it, they came during last week and now it's still like this. Let's say, Father, let your power rest upon our AC units. Every power that is contrary, we cast them out, we cast them out, cast them out. Satan, lose your hold over this AC. Lose your hold. Lose your grip over the AC. We cast you out of this church. You are a devourer. We bind you. Lose your hold over the AC. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to pray one prayer, and if you are sick in your body, you want me to pray with you, you will just come out, then we pray. But this prayer point, because you are cleansed, because you have embraced the truth, it will work for you. I said it will work for you. I started praying this prayer when the Lord gave me this prayer point. And commotion is in the camp of the enemy. I don't want to tell where that thing is happening right now. But it's a very powerful prayer. But there is one of my daughter that traveled to UK. She called me and said, mommy, there's somebody that is choking me in the dream. And when she opened her eyes, she saw the back view of a woman walking out. I said, open to Hebrews chapter 1 verse 14. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 14 is a very powerful prayer. But those who embrace the truth, those who will not fight the truth, those who will walk with the truth, those who will live a pure and holy life, this work for them like fire. Let's read it together. Are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation? Who is that person that is troubling you? Karibo Shandala, Baba Baba. You better don't trouble anybody in this congregation. We are going to pray now. We are going to say, leave that passage, please. We are going to say, in the name of Jesus Christ, I release militant ministry spirits. According to Hebrews chapter 1, verse 14. To go to the camp of my enemies and start to deal with them. 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 I release. Militant ministry spirit. To go to the camp of my enemies. To start to deal with them right now. I release. Militant ministry spirit. I want everybody to pray this prayer. Wherever you are, pray this prayer. Marekete kerebo shekede. In Jesus' name we pray. Don't mind if you are sweating out sickness. In those days when we gave our life to Christ, when you are praying and you are not sweating, you are not praying yet. Because you want to sweat out fever. You see that girl I gave that prayer point, her sleep started becoming like a newborn baby. So one day she called me again and said, Mommy, that thing. I said, Go to Hebrews chapter 1 verse 14. Let's pray it together on the phone. We prayed it. Up to now, she called me and said, everything is just going fine. You know, let me tell you, this ministering spirit, they are waiting for you. Heirs of salvation. All of you are not making use of them. They don't have job to do. But when they hear in the name of Jesus, they are like zombie. You just tell them, stay there permanently. And we are not just sending ordinary. We are sending the militant ones. He said, let no man trouble me. For I bear upon my body the mark of the Lord. Everything must go fine for you. You're going to say, in the name of Jesus Christ, I release militant ministry spirit. According to Hebrews chapter 1, verse 14, go to the camp of my enemies and start to deal with them. Start to deal with them. Start to deal with them. Go to the camp of my enemies. Start to deal with them. Go to the camp of my enemies. Start to deal with them. In Jesus' name we pray. Let me tell you, immediately you were praying, the Spirit of the Lord said, tell them, if your heart is not right with your brother, it won't work. If you see your brother or your sister progressing and you are bittered, or you see them being praised, you are bittered, this prayer will not work for you. If you have envy, bitterness, don't just shout anyhow. You know, this place is a pillar of truth. Oh. We will not bend it. Don't shout. Check your heart first. When you check your heart first, you could see that woman I told the truth. She checked her life, forgave, even called her husband, greet, how are you? I hope everything is fine. She called me back and said, he's just answering me. And I said, he's not your husband. Just make sure you greet him and then have clean heart. Today, she's free. Everything is fine. We are going to say it again. In the name of Jesus Christ, I release militant ministry spirit. According to Hebrews chapter 1, verse 14, go to the camp of my enemies and start to deal with them. Deal with them, John. Deal with them. Deal with them. Deal with them. Holy Ghost, yes, deal with them, deal with them. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you very much for taking time to listen to this message. I want to believe that you are really blessed. Peradventure, you just joined us when the message has already started. I want to encourage you to join us again on Saturday, and we will continue where we stopped this week, next week, same time. And if you choose to worship with us, we are located at 15227 Old Richmond Road, Sugarland, Texas, 77498. You will be glad you came. God bless you.
I'm just in the studio.
Hey,
I call you right back when I'm done.
I'ma hit you back,
right? Put in it work, I'm in the booth for the song.
I'ma hit you back.
Put in impression, and you know he's number one.
In the studio,
I'm just in the studio.
Houston, Pavilion, RCCG, what's good? Yo, Vic Tizzle got the chef hat, sweet aroma. Cooking up a beat, make your body feel opposite of odor. Spirits don't die, so we don't pronounce death. But if they try, yo, we will put them in a coma. Fire, fire, prayer, only way that I survive. But prayer losing popularity, high five. Mark 9:29, the King James is the only place that you'll find prayer these days. What a shame, the church is...
Oh boy, why am I here? There's gotta be something better than this.
Report. Have it on my desk completed by noon. And I'll be in conference till then, so hold all of my calls and reschedule all my appointments.
And that's including the 2 o'clock?
Everything.
Okay, yes ma'am.
Any other questions?
No, that's it.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Here we go again.
Are you living up to your full potential? Is where you are where you need to be. What you need is the power of vision. Come, join us this summer, July 11th to July 13th, for RCCGNA's 5th Annual Young Adults and Singles Convention, located in Chicago, Illinois, 400 Park Boulevard at the Westin Hotel. Just go to rccgnayasm.org and register now.
This song is for champions. This song is our anthem. They know us by the way that we live, not only by the words we speak. You know words can be cheap, cause you can say that you a Christian, you read and you pray, but your lifestyle is saying you are Lucifer's slave. Because you cheat and you lie, you feed your pride, letting loose the beast inside. The flesh is alive. You see the way we roll. We bury the flesh on a daily, never let it resurrect.
We're living holy.
Yeah.
Righteous,
you know we are.
With an army of angels. That's how we roll.
And plan B, stick with the master's plan. We are the children, not letting go of our father's hands. Never letting go, won't give the enemy a chance. Yeah, heaven is the goal, so we'll live a lifestyle that glorifies the one who rose. He's coming back to take us home. Will he take you home, or will he leave you alone? We don't smoke, we don't drink, we don't cheat and lie. We never alone, the spirit lives inside. The spirit's holy, by his grace so are we. And he protects us all day, even in our sleep. So we invite you, come and roll the way we roll. On fire, but no need for the water hose. Are you in danger? Christ can overcome those obstacles. If you're lacking, he can provide you a pocket full.
Living holy,
you know we are.
Righteous, with an army of angels. That's how we roll.
Full armor of God, full armor.
Yeah.
Full armor of God, full armor. Yo, put on a whole armor. Can't survive this life without the fear of the Father. Ephesians 6, let's read, let's learn. Had to learn a lesson, feel free to ask your questions. Let's turn to verse 13. If you're there, you could read. Don't be scared, we your team. We just trying to get better, so we helping one another. Don't want to remain undercovers. We the light of...